Although I'm not a Ford guy, I absolutely love the look of Raptor lights. And lately I've started to see them a lot on the new Tacomas, the 4Runners, and even the Tundras. And I even thought that they came like that stock, but apparently they don't. These are aftermarket additions. So I personally own a 80 series Land Cruiser, this one right here. And I wanna give my Land Cruiser a new look. You know, it's older, it's the paint's kinda faded, so I wanted to give it a modern look, but keeping that classic 80 series style. My father-in-law showed me what he did with his Tundra. It's an older early 2000s Tundra, and I loved the look and I loved the idea. His buddy did it for him, and I kind of copied that idea. And so in this video, I'm going to show you with 5 easy steps how you can do this to your older Toyota truck, whether it's a Land Cruiser, a Tundra, a Tacoma, whatever it is, you're going to be able to do it in 5 easy steps. The grill might be a little different, but the concept is the same and it's super easy. So I'm going to show you how it used to look, how my Land Cruiser used to look old and it looked kind of sad, and how it looks now, much better. It looks very modern, but it still has that classic look. So that's what we're going to hope to achieve here in this video. All right, so I'm going to go over everything you're going to need for this installation, this DIY. So you're gonna need 3 or 4 amber lights. I originally chose 3, but I decided to go with 4 in the end. It just looked a lot better. You're gonna need 18 gauge wire, red and black. You can get this at any hardware store. I got it at Napa. You're gonna need wire cutter tools. You can get these anywhere as well. Wire heat shrink connector that's watertight. I got this at Harbor Freight. It was like a pack of 10 for like $3, super affordable. Some zip ties you can get basically anywhere. And that's about it. Very simple, very basic tools that you can get virtually anywhere. And I'm gonna link everything in the description below so you can find it either at Amazon or at your local hardware store. All right, step one is actually the most important, but it's the easiest, and that is to go ahead and hit that like button and to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I would truly appreciate it because my channel is very small and I wanna grow. So please help a brother out. Anyways, that's it for step one. All right, step two was pretty straightforward, and it's to remove the front grill. This is usually super easy. For me, it was only 4 bolts and it just popped right off. And I took this opportunity to paint my front grill. So if you wanna see the process of what I used to paint my grill and get it in the condition that I did, just go ahead and leave a comment below. And if I get enough requests, I'll make a video. So step three is gonna be position your lights where you want them. So you wanna lay them out and see exactly where you're gonna have them positioned on the grill. And this is important because originally I thought that I wanted 3 lights, but after having them all set up right there, I realized it wasn't gonna look good. So I went and bought another light, and that was helpful because it made it look a lot better and a lot cleaner. And the second part of step three is to prepare your lights. To do this, I got about 1.5 feet on each side of red and black wire, so ground and positive wire. And what you'll notice here is that the positive wire on these lights was actually black, so I had to chop that off, and then I cut it, and then I added just red wire all the way through. And I did that for all of the lights. And this is important because I didn't want to get confused. I didn't want it to be half black and half red. So you'll notice here how I connected it right there. And then I just kind of crimped it and we were good to go. You're gonna wanna do it to all the lights that you wanna add to your front grill. And then we can move on to step four. Step four is to zip tie the lights into position and to route the wires. Now I chose to drill a hole in my grill to route the wires and as well as to zip tie my lights in. This helped it be a lot more sturdier, and I just preferred this method. Now if you don't have access to a drill, you could definitely get away with not having to do this. My father-in-law's setup is just held on by zip ties, and his have been working just fine for months now. So don't worry if you don't have a drill. It's really gonna depend on how your grill is set up. Now, to route the wires, I drilled holes where I wanted my wires to run because I wanted it to be very clean and very organized. And this is important if you run any type of wiring. You want it to be very clean and organized because you wanna be able to identify a point of failure in case anything does come up. And I'm going to show you on a diagram here that I drew out myself, very fancy, exactly how I wired these up. So first I chose to go with my ground wire first, and then I chose to go with my red wire, which was my power wire. And I'm going to show you here on my diagram how I did it, but I'm also going to show you exactly how I did it on the grill so you can kind of see both of them. So basically I connected these two and I added a little butt connector and then I ran a wire. And then I did the same thing for these other two, added a butt connector, then I ran a wire. And then finally I connected the last two, added a butt connector, and then I ran a wire. And that was basically, that wire is gonna go directly to the ground somewhere on my Land Cruiser. And I did the same exact process for my positive wire. So I got got two lights, connected them on one end to the butt connector, and then I added a wire. And the same thing with the other one, connected them two up, and then ran a wire to the butt connector. And then I ran one wire, and that wire was ready to be connected to the power source.
All right, and one more time, right? We're running just the ground, because this is the exact same thing we're gonna do for the power, or the red one. So we ran these two, and they ran up through these holes, and we connected them right here. Then we got another piece of wire, right? And then we left that like that. And then we did over here. These two, these go up here, this one goes up here, and we connected these two, just like this one, and then we ran another wire, just like that. So we have that here, that's the other wire. And so, at the end of those, we ran another wire, and we connect it here. So this one's just gonna run all the way to the ground, and I'm just gonna zip tie these right here. And now we're gonna do the same thing for these red ones, same exact way, and then we're gonna have it right here at the end.
All right, moving on to step number five, and that's to wire everything up. Now I chose my power source to be my side marker light, so I can turn that on and turn that off whenever I want. And I decided that this would be the best option because the side marker lights are yellow anyways. And before doing that, we needed a test with a light tester to ensure that we had the right wire chosen for the power source. So we turned on the switch, and we got our tester out, and we tested. Now it's important for you to test this because if you don't know for sure which wire it is, you could have chosen a wrong one and then you could have started troubleshooting things without even knowing that you needed to troubleshoot it. So it's important to get a good solid test and make sure that you have chosen the correct wire, and then that way there's no doubt that there is power to that wire and you don't have to troubleshoot something that doesn't need to be troubleshot. Also, it's important to get a good ground wire for this, or a good ground. When we were testing, we didn't get a good ground and we're kind of lost and confused, like why isn't this powering up? Then we realized we hadn't gotten a good ground. So it's very, very important to get a good ground, just as much as it's important to get a good light. Now that we know which wire is giving us power, we're going to use this blue quick splice connector here that I have already attached, and we're going to splice it together. And it's actually very simple. You just put the wire that you want to have a power to in through there, and then you just press it down like so. And you'll notice that I basically kept it on the spool because I didn't know how long it was going to be or how long I needed this wire to be. So I kept that on there and I just spliced it in. And then once I did that, I tested it again. I wanted to make sure that it did have power, so I connected the light up, and I used the same wire that I had before, the same ground, and I tested with our test light, and I confirmed that we had light, so we knew we had power going to this wire and that I spliced it properly. All right, the next thing is I'm finding a ground location. As you see here, I found a perfect location right next to it, and I basically just loosened up that ground bolt, and then I slipped my ground wire in through there, and I gave myself plenty of slack because I don't know how long it's gonna be. So I used this little connector here, and I made sure that it was nice and sturdy, and I basically wired that in there. I fit that on there and then I tightened it up. And so I knew now that I had a good power source and a good ground wire. And now we're basically ready to position our grill and to wire everything in. You'll notice that I left myself plenty of slack on both the red and the black wire because in case I ever have to remove my grill or anything does happen, I'll have plenty of slack and plenty of room to play with just in case. Also, what we're gonna do now is we're gonna put the grill back on and we're gonna connect the red to the red, the black to the black, and that's basically it. After that, it's just cable management. So I zip tied all my cables as closely as possible to the grill. And that's the entire process, guys. Very, very straightforward, super easy. And it's very important, like I said, for cable management, because you don't want that radiator to be heating up your wires and then burning through them. So bring them in as close to the grill as possible. And you'll notice here how I wired them just right and just attached to the grill, so that way they're not bouncing around or moving around. And this is important also because you don't want your lights to be flickering in case there was a loose wire in there. So that's the entire process, guys. So let's look at the finished product. So first, let's see how it used to look. Yes, it's an 80 series. It still looks good, but I mean, it's not as good as it does look now. It still maintains that classic vintage 80 series Land Cruiser look, but it has that extra pop, that extra flair, and I just absolutely love it. So let me know what you guys think. If you guys were able to successfully do this on your vintage Toyota truck, let me know. I'd love to hear it. And also, thanks to every single one of you guys that have decided to subscribe to my YouTube channel. I never thought that I'd have that much support. And so I'm super, super grateful and very humbled that so many of you have decided to subscribe. So thank you guys so much. I hope this video is helpful to you, and I hope you learned something. Thank you for watching.